Help me out. What year does that calendar say? Tell me it says 2024. Because if it says 2024, why am I still going to people's computers and seeing these passwords? So let me tell you a story. Last week I went to a retail store and I had to go to a desk where somebody was entering orders because these were special orders that they could only do on a certain computer a certain way. And so, okay, no problem. So I go over to the computer, I go to the laptop, and what do I see on the laptop? Right here, as a username and a password. And my mind is blown because the place where I'm at, I know the person doing the ordering entry, and with that username and password, I am fairly certain that I would have had access to credit cards, addresses, names, all kinds of sensitive information. So I asked about the password. I said, you know, it's not a good idea to have this sitting here when you have all these people walking up to your computer. And she said, I know, I don't normally have my laptop out here in the public area, and I kind of forgot about it. So she quickly took the post-it note and stuck it under her laptop, which I guess is better than being right on top of the laptop. But at the end of the day, the issue is that data, that password is compromised now, and you really need to deal with that. We talked about it a little bit, and it was one of those cases where, yep, I just don't remember passwords very well. And being in information security, my first thought was, well, what if you only had to remember one password? And so that's what I want to talk about today. I just want to give you a high-level overview of 1Password, which is a password manager. It's a kind of tool that you use with your computer, and you can use it with your phone, whether it's iPhone, Android, you can use it on a Windows computer, PC, even Linux computers. But the idea behind a password manager is it's a vault system. So it stores all of your logins and your passwords so that you don't have to remember them. And it also offers a number of other features. Now, I know the first thing you're going to say to me is, well, what if somebody gets into that password manager? Won't they have all my passwords? Well, yes, if they were able to get into it. The beauty with something like 1Password is it uses multiple levels of encryption. When you create your account, you actually create an email account, you create a password, then you create a password that is specific for your vault, which should be a complicated password. Then there's a security key that's also generated. And you cannot get into that password vault unless you have all of that information. The 1Password company does not have that security key. When you create your account, it gives you an emergency toolkit, which contains the password, the secure password, all those kind of things that you would file away someplace safe, because nobody can get into your password vault without all the information in that document. But at the end of the day, all you need to remember is a single password to unlock that vault. The beauty of that password vault is it does more than just store your passwords. It does things like monitor your accounts that you've got in there for breaches. So if a website, let's say, you know, a third-party credit monitoring system is hacked, well, 1Password will know about this, and the next time you go to log in, you'll have a big red banner that says, hey, your password's been compromised. Would you like to change it? And it'll take you right through the steps you need to change that password. Some other security features that come in with this is duplicate password detection. So if you import a bunch of passwords into 1Password, it will immediately identify any passwords that have been reused across multiple websites. That's critical, because if a hacker gets a hold of 1Password that you've used somewhere, there's a good chance they know that you've probably used that password elsewhere, and heaven forbid that password be your email password, because if they can get into your email, they'll see all the other accounts that have been sent to you over the years, and they will quickly go and try to use that username, that email address, and that password on all these websites, and they can do an automated attack, which is really fast. So you want to have something like 1Password that's guarding your back and protecting you, alerting you if you've got duplicate passwords or compromised passwords. The other fun thing? I don't know if it's a fun thing, but it's a really useful thing, is when you use something like 1Password, when you go to a website, it will generate passwords for you, and they're complex passwords. And you never need to remember them because 1Password's got your back. It will record the website, the username, and the password so that you don't have to remember it. In fact, I don't know what most of my passwords are. If you ask me, I could go into 1Password and I could look it up, but it's not really useful to know what those passwords are because 1Password does all the work for me. When I revisit a website, I fill in my username and it'll automatically prompt, do you want to fill in your password? And it'll do that for me. On a Mac, it uses biometrics. So all I have to do is use my finger, touch the fingerprint reader, and it'll fill that password. Another thing that 1Password can do is protect you from phishing attacks. So phishing attacks are those things where you get those emails that that want you to click a link and they take you to a website that looks like the main website you're trying to go to, but it's actually a cloned website. Well, when you go to that website and you go to enter your username and password, 1Password is going to say, hey, I don't have a password stored for this site, because it's going to be a different address than what you've recorded earlier. Let's say you use Chase Bank and you normally log into Chase every day, and then one day you get an email that looks like it came from Chase Bank, and so you click the link thinking it's something important. Unbeknownst to you, you've gone to a false domain, and it probably wouldn't even have the word Chase in it, but it might be something like chasebank.com.ru, you know, something like that. Well, when you go to log in with 1Password, it's going to notice the .ru and say, that's not a .com. There's no valid password for this site. This is probably a phishing site. And it'll prompt you and say, hey, are you sure this is the website you want to go to? So it's kind of helping you protect yourself against spoofed attacks. It happens all the time that people get compromised on these spoofed websites. So having another piece of technology that's watching over your back to protect you from that is a lifesaver. Literally, it can save you time, energy, and money by protecting you. So in an upcoming video, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go through a whole scenario about how to set up a 1Password account. We will start at the very beginning. We'll go to the website, we'll create an account, we'll see what the security looks like, get the security key, we'll show the emergency document, and then we'll walk through the process of actually creating some accounts inside of 1Password, and you'll see how easy it is. And again, this is something that you can use on just about every platform. I highly recommend it. I'm not sponsored by them. I just firmly believe in the product. I've been using it for almost 15 years now. I've gone through several iterations, and I cannot count the number of times that it has saved me time and effort in terms of having to worry about passwords, remembering passwords, finding passwords from those obscure websites that maybe you only go to once every 2 years. So watch for that upcoming video. In the meantime, get rid of all your post-it notes. Let's stop writing those down. Let's make you a little bit more secure.